नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम द चैप्टर इशू ऑफ डिबेंचर्स. सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट रीड द टॉपिक. टॉपिक इज अकाउंटिंग फॉर इशू ऑफ डिबेंचर्स कंसीडरिंग द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस ऑफ रिडम्पशन. हियर रिडम्पशन मींस रीपेमेंट ऑफ डिबेंचर्स. लाइक सपोज इफ आई हैव इशूड, माय कंपनी हैज इशूड डिबेंचर्स फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ 6 years, then obviously what I'm going to do in that case, I'm going to give debentures to the debenture holders and will take money from them. Now after 6 years, I have to repay the money back. Fine, I have to give the money back to the debenture holders. So this process is known as redemption. Redemption means repayment of debentures. And like suppose if I have issued debentures to the debenture holders and they have given me money for 6 years or 7 years. Now after 7 years, I'll pay the money back to them. So this is known as the process of redemption. Now this year, the CBSE has deleted this chapter from your syllabus. It means redemption of debentures, though it is in your book, but now it's not a part of your syllabus. But still, one topic of that chapter is still a part of this chapter, that is issue of debentures. It means one topic from redemption will be discussed in this chapter, that is issue of debentures. So the topic is accounting for issue of debentures considering the terms and conditions of redemption. Now let me explain you the meaning of the topic first of all. See, whenever we issue the debentures new, that time only all the terms and conditions were decided. Suppose you want to buy the debentures of my company, then obviously you would like to know in advance only, know that the way by which I'm going to give the payment to you, or the method or the various terms and conditions, we always decide this thing in advance. Like suppose it may also happen that debentures were issued at par, but they are going to be redeemed on premium. ये भी तो हो सकता है कि debentures par पर issue है बट उनका रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम पर हो, डिबेंचर्स पार पर इशूड है बट उनका रिडम्पशन डिस्काउंट पर हो, या डिबेंचर्स पार पर इशूड है उनका रिडम्पशन भी पार पर हो. सो इट मीन्स रिडम्पशन कैसे होगा, कि रिडम्पशन विल बी डन ईदर एट पार और एट प्रीमियम और एट डिस्काउंट. ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी ऑलवेज डिसाइड इन एडवांस. एडवांस मीन्स एट द टाइम ऑफ इशूइंग द डिबेंचर्स. गॉट इट? सो देर आर 6 cases. And we are going to discuss all the 6 cases today so that you can understand how to solve the question. Now let me explain you one more thing. Solving the question here simply means that only you have to pass the journal entry from the given data. Entries of the issue, keeping in mind the condition of the redemption. You don't have to pass the entry of the redemption in the question until and unless it is told. But I'm going to make you explain the both. Though these entries are the part of the next chapter, but still you should know that what entries are like do we have to pass in the case of redemption. So we are going to discuss all the cases. Once again I'm repeating that in the question some data will be given to you. Data in sense the terms and conditions of the issue, the terms and conditions of the redemption. And keeping in mind the terms and conditions of the redemption, you have to pass the entries for the issue. So I hope now this point is clear. So now let's discuss the first case. First case is when debentures are issued at par and redeemable at par. Redeemable means कि जितने पर आपने debenture issue किया आप उतने पर ही उनकी payment करेंगे. Par means at face value. Means if debentures have been issued at 100, fine, and we have to redeem the debentures on 100 only. So entry for issue and entry for redemption we have to pass, but entries for issue will be passed keeping in mind the entries or the terms and conditions of the redemption. So now see, as I told you in the previous videos also, that in reality what basically happens, that we always call the lump sum only, we never go for installments. So these questions will come in the exam from the point of view of this thing only, that we are going to call the whole money from the debenture holder in lump sum. It means that if they are interested in buying the debentures of our company, then they have to give rupees 100 to us in lump sum. We are not going to make any calls. I hope this point is clear. The questions will be asked in the paper from this point of view. Like from this topic, no question will come of this sort, that you have to pass the entry for allotment separately, for first call separately, and for final call separately. No such question will come. You have to make the entry for the lump sum. Got it? So now see, as I told you that we have to pass the entry for the issue, keeping in mind the conditions of the redemption. Now here, what is the condition of the redemption? That we have to redeem the debentures at par only. So what entry we are going to pass? See, simple. We are going to call complete 100 rupees from the debenture holders, right? And as am I going to call complete 100 in lump sum, so I'll use the word to debenture application and allotment. We always open one joint account. So bank account debited to debenture application and allotment. And next entry we are going to pass is debenture application and allotment debited to debentures. I hope this point is clear to everybody. Now, as I told you that these entries we always pass keeping in mind the conditions of the redemption. Now here the condition of the redemption is same as that of issue. Means we are issuing debentures at 100 and we are making payment of debentures at 100 only. So no accounting treatment or nothing new you will find in the entries of issue. That's why you have not seen anything new. You are going to see something new in the coming cases. Got it? So now we have to pass the entries for redemption also. Though it will not be asked in the paper, but still I am going to tell you how do we pass the entries so that at least something, some new should be like you should learn. Now, as I told you, redemption means repayment. Repayment means we are going to take debenture back from the debenture holders, and debentures are certificates, fine. So we are going to take those certificates back and we are going to make payment to them. So jab humne payment kar denge to wo to hamare debenture holder hai hi nahi. It means those debentures have been cancelled now. Debentures are having credit balances. If I want to, you know, cancel them, then I should debit. If I am making payment of my liability, obviously my liability will decrease, no? Liabilities always have a credit balance. Now if I want to decrease, then I need to debit them. So debenture account debited to debenture holder. Now how much do we have to pay to them? 100. Because we have to redeem the debentures at par only. Par means at the face value. I have assumed that the face value is 100. Face value could be 10 also, face value could be 50 also. It depends upon the question. Then, now as we are making payment to the debenture holders, no, because we have taken debentures back from them and now we are going to make them the payment. So debenture holder becomes the receiver. And debenture holder are natural persons just like you and I. So the rule of personal accounts will be applicable. Debenture holder will become the receiver. So debit the receiver. And as we are going to make payment to them, so money will go out of the business. So it becomes debenture holder account debited to bank account. And how much we are going to pay? 100 rupees we are going to pay. I hope this first case is clear to you all, that when debentures are issued at par and redeemable at par. I'll tell you what you have to solve in the paper. You have to pass only these entries in the paper. You don't have to pass these entries in reality. Reality means in this chapter. Fine. But these entries will be passed only when we are, or only when we know the terms and conditions of the redemption. But still I am going to explain you both the cases. Both the cases means I will explain you the entries of issue also and the entries of redemption also. There are total 6 cases and we have discussed just one first case yet. So let's start with the second case. Yes girls, so now let's discuss the next case. Read the statement. Next case is when debentures are issued at discount and redeemable at par. What does it mean? It means that debentures have been issued at less than the face value. So I assume, let's say the face value is 100 and we have issued debentures at discount. Discount means less than the face value. Let's say I have issued debentures at rupees 90. It means 10 rupees discount have been given. So what does this line mean? This line means that we have issued at 90. Got it? But we are going to redeem them at 100. or in simple language what I should say, that we have taken rupees 90 from the debenture holders, issued, that we have taken rupees 90 from the debenture holders, but we are going to pay rupees 100 to them. I hope this point is clear, that we are going to issue the debentures at discount, but we have to redeem them at par. So it means that we have taken rupees 90 from the debenture holders, but we are going to repay rupees 100 to them. Got it? So now let's pass the entries. First of all, we have to pass the entries for issue. I hope you know the meaning of issue. Issue means to give debentures to the debenture holders and to take money from them. And redemption means to give money back to them and to take take our debentures back. Issue means उन्हें debentures देना और उनसे money लेना. Redemption means जो debentures हमने उन्हें issue दिए थे वो debentures उनसे वापस ले रहे हैं और जितना money उन्होंने हमें दिया था उतना money हम उन्हें वापस कर रहे हैं. So issue means giving debentures and taking money, and redemption means giving the money back and taking our debentures. So I hope now the things are clear. It means that when we issued debentures to them, no, that time we gave one debentures to them for rupees 90, and now when we are going to repay their money, then we are going to give rupees 100 to them. So what entries we have to pass for the issue? That we have collected rupees 90 from them. Got it? Because the cost of one debenture is 90 at the time of issue. So bank account debited to debenture application and allotment 90. Then next entry would be debenture application and allotment 90. Now see, the value of debenture is 100. I have issued at 90. It means I have given discount on issue of debentures. Got it? And this discount on issue of debenture is a capital loss, because as I told you that we don't issue debentures on daily basis. So this rupee 10 become a capital loss for us. So we'll write it as discount on issue of debentures. Got it? And 2, debentures 100. Now, what entries we have to pass at the time of redemption? Now, we have taken rupees 90, but we have to pay rupees 100 to them. So again, debentures was our liability. Liability thi hamari. Hum unhe repay karenge, our liability will decrease. So debenture account will be debited to debenture holder. How much do we have to pay them? 100 and 100. Got it? And then debenture holder becomes the receiver and money goes out. So this is the second case. Now see, these entries also you have already learned, you have already seen. One thing I would like to tell you, that there will be change in the entries for issue only when there will be a change at the time of, or you may say in the conditions of the redemption. If we are redeeming the debentures at par only, no, then there will be no effect on the entries of the issue. Got it? These things will be clear to you when you go to the next cases. That time you will understand everything. Got it? So have some patience and move to the case number 3. Now let's start with the third case. Third case is when debentures are issued at premium but redeemable at par. What does it mean? See, I'm saying that the face value or the par value, face or the par value of debenture is 100. Got it? I have issued debentures at premium. Premium means more than the face value. Let's say I have issued debentures at 105. It means 105 is the cost of one debentures. but I have to redeem these debentures at 100 only. It means that at the face value, or in other terms, what we can call it, that I have given the debentures to the debenture holders at 105. It means that if they want to buy one debenture of my company, then they have to pay 105 to me, and then I'll give only one debenture to them. But jab in debentures ki hum repayment karenge, that time I'll pay only rupees 100 to that particular debenture holder. Let's say Ram has purchased one debenture of my company, then obviously I have given one debenture to Ram for 105. Now after 6 years, when I have to give money back to the Ramu, so that मैं अपना जो debenture उन्हें दिया था उनसे वापस ले सकें, तो अपना debenture उनसे वापस लेने के लिए I have to give only rupees 100 to him. It means I have issued debenture at 105, but I'm going to redeem that debenture at rupees 100 only. So now this case is also not new for you. You have already done it. So let's see how. Now I told you in the previous case also that the entries of issue will change only when there will be a change in the terms and conditions of redemption. अभी तक redemption के terms and conditions में कोई change नहीं आया. Change in sense कि जितने पर debentures की means basically कि redemption जो हो रहा है वो par पर ही हो रहा है. आपने first case देखा when issued at par, redemption at par, तब भी redemption par पर था. In the previous case, what did you notice? That issued at discount, but redemption is to be done at par. In this case, issued at premium, but still redemption is at par only. It means that if redemption is at par, then there is no change in the entries of the issue. You'll find no new entry, nothing new in the entry. You have already done the first entry also, the entry which we did in the second case also, discount one, and the third entry also will not be new for you. वो आपके लिए नई नहीं होगी. Things will change जब redemption change हो जाए. Redemption change हो जाए means redemption par पर ना हो, rather redemption आपका premium पर हो जाए या redemption discount पर हो जाए. Then only the things will change. So first of all that we'll see in the fourth, fifth and sixth case. Till the like first, second and third case were safe. Got it? So pass the entry. Bank account will be debited. How much I have collected from Ram? 105, and I have given one debenture to him. Now 105 I have collected, you know, lump sum. So I have to open joint account, two debenture application and allotment. Now debenture application and allotment will be debited, and we are going to transfer this money into debentures account. It means that now Ram has become a debenture holder. Debenture means the face value, and two, securities premium 5. And this securities premium is a capital profit for you all. Now, there will be no change in the entry of the issue as I told you. So, what entry we are going to pass? Debentures account debited to debenture holder. How much we have to pay? 100 only. And debenture holder will be debited, and money goes out. So these were the three cases. See, जो भी entries issue की हैं, ये entries तो already pass करते ही थे. Nothing new was there. Got it? New things will come in the next video when the terms and conditions of redemption will change.